So the announcements that come with the class are the ones that I send out before the semester starts. They're important and you might need to reference them throughout the semester. So you should take note that there is a Getting Started in Art 1280 Photoshop software announcement. That announcement is basically these videos in written form. So some people may like to listen to my videos and some people may like to read more. But make sure that you're skimming through it so that everything that I'm saying is also what's covered in these announcements. There's an announcement about printed semester schedules, and so there is, when I get there I'll show you, but there is a section of the course that will allow you to print the semester schedule. It kind of maps out what you should be doing and when, and my weekly announcements that say, hey, you should be doing this on Monday and Tuesday, and you should be doing that on Wednesday and Thursday, they will coincide with that printed schedule, and you can print a copy yourself. Or I like to print them and hang them outside of 1-165. It's a classroom over at the South City campus. It's good for you to know where that classroom is because when we have things like free printing days for the Photoshop class, they'll be in that room. And so if you just walk down the hall and you see them taped to the wall, you can snag one and then you don't have to print a copy yourself. I would caution you though, those are only for sections that I, Jessica, am teaching. If other teachers change the due date schedule and they don't follow the schedule that I use, those schedules will not be applicable. And the sign that I'll post on the door will clearly say these schedules are for section 501 only or 504 only, whatever section I happen to be teaching. There's a little announcement about coursework and corrected videos. So the Photoshop class has gone through a lot of changes in the last couple years. We've revamped the entire thing. We've made it a requirement for all visual art and design students. Before, we used to have separate Photoshop classes for photography or multimedia or graphic design majors. Now, every single visual art and design student takes Art 1280 as a foundation precursor to whatever the advanced Photoshop would be in their area. As part of that, we went through some growing pains, and I am in the process of re-recording all of our videos, but I may not get to all of them every semester. And so you may come across a video that's showing you how to do, let's go with that selection that I keep talking about, selections, chapter 9. It might start talking about skills-based activities, and it might have demos of me doing these activities, and I might say, okay, make sure you turn that in by Thursday. Those videos will have a little asterisk under them explaining that they are videos from a previous semester where the activity that's being demoed is not required anymore. If that happens, you can still watch the video and you can still do the exercises along with me because the images are mostly found free in your textbook. And if they are not images from your textbook, you can just Google and find images that are similar to practice on. It is in your best interest to practice those skills as they are covered in your textbook, but they may not be required for submission, so just take that with a grain of salt. A little bit more background on that, we used to have students do 150 skills-based activities every semester, testing every single skill that we cover in the book and in the course, and we decided that wasn't the best path to take for the course, and so we don't require those submissions to be turned in anymore, but they're still covered in the book, and you're still expected to read the book and to perform the activities. You're just not required to turn them in and get a grade for them. If you can do the test without turning in 25 different skills, then you'll get the grade on the test and not on the 25 skills and then on the test again. With that being said, if it intimidates you to have to do all these skills-based activities on your own through the textbook and you don't feel comfortable before you take the exam, you can always submit files to me, Jessica, via the Canvas inbox and say, hey, can you take a look at this? Can you see if I'm doing the selection right? And I'll be happy to take a look at it and give you some feedback before you go and take the test. Okay, there are two other announcements that you should read in their entirety, and they are using SLCC All Access and using Google Drive to submit coursework in Art 1280. SLCC All Access is a free platform for you to access Adobe software and other different types of software through the college. And so if you don't have Adobe on your computer and you don't want to come to the Visual Art and Design Computer Lab, but you still want to figure out a way to access Photoshop, SLCC All Access may be an option for you, so you should click on that. There's another video inside there that will explain how you can use SLCC All Access. And then last but not least, there is a link on using Google Drive to submit your coursework. In Art 1280, you will need to use Google Drive to store your coursework, and then instead of uploading giant files to me through Canvas, which Canvas doesn't like very much, it takes forever to upload, You're just going to give me the link to the file, and it's important that you upload it, you organize your files, and you make sure that the link that you're giving me is public. By default, it'll be set to private, so you'll need to change it to public so that when I click on it, I can see it. For our class, you're going to need to do that every time you have a submission. And when you take the exams, there's one exam per module. When you take the checkpoint exam, the last three or so questions on every exam are hands-on activities where you have to do something, save the file, and then give me the link. And so you need to make sure that you know how to use Google Drive before you start those exams, or you're going to get all the way to the end of the exam and panic because you don't know how to submit the file, because there's no option to upload files on the exam. You have to copy and paste the URL to where you've saved it online. Now, if you don't want to use Google Drive and you're really good at Dropbox, I don't care how you give me your files, if you have a way to store them online, as long as you provide me with a public link. And so I recommend Google Drive because everybody has a Google account, because you are students at Salt Lake Community College and your Bruin Mail email is a Gmail account. But if there's some other way that you'd like to store your files and share them, as long as you can give me a public shareable link, then that will work for us. If you are confused about it or you have any questions on whether or not some approach that you want to take will work, email me. Either email me at the email address listed on your course syllabus, or just email me directly through Canvas, and I can make sure that your link is working before you start all of your submissions. Okay, I'm going to end this video, and before you come back to the next video, I want you to make sure you read through any announcements that you see via the Announcements tab before we move forward to the Syllabus and the Grades tab.